way of man and not a way of God.
Look at Proverbs chapter 21 and beginning at verse number 2. And notice something else the proverb writer says. He says, every way of man is right in his own eyes. Mm-hmm. That's why you have to allow God to direct your steps. Whatever you do for God religiously, there ought to be some command in New Testament worship for you to do what you're doing to God. And if you can't find a command, if you can't find the authorization in New Testament worship, then this is something that God doesn't want to be done, because everything that God wants us to do in our worship, in our service to Him, He has put it in His Word. Every way of man is right in his own eyes, but it's the Lord that ponders the heart. Look with me at Matthew chapter 7. And beginning in verse number 13, Jesus warns us, don't follow the majority. It's only a few that's going to find the right way. And so you need to follow that right and that narrow way. Matthew chapter 7, and beginning in verse number 13, the Bible says, enter ye in at the straight gate. For wide is the gate, and broad is the way that leadeth to destruction. And many there be which go in therein. It's nothing new. It shouldn't surprise us that multitudes of people are following the wrong way. And sometimes people get caught up in the crowd and say, well, they got so many folk over there, they must be doing something right. They got so many ministries going on, they must be doing something right. I mean, look at what all they're doing. Just good works alone. Hear me now. Just good works alone doesn't allow you a guaranteed seat in the kingdom. As a matter of fact, in Matthew chapter 6, the Lord warned the disciples to not do their good deeds before men just to be seen of them. Because if you do that as men pleases, then you don't have no reward of your Father which is in heaven. Jesus is not impressed with your just doing good deeds. The way you're going to make heaven your home is not just through doing good, but it's through honestly being good. And the only way to be good is to follow God's word to the letter. The Lord indicates here that many are going to follow that broad way. It's a more popular way.
Yeah.
It's a more fleshly gratifying way. It's a more attractive way, because in this way, very little change has to take place. But Jesus says, we have to enter in at the straight gate. Why, Lord? Because straight, verse 14, is the gate, and narrow is the way which leadeth unto life. And ain't gonna be but a few that's gonna find. Just because everybody is doing it doesn't make it right. We've got too many people in religion that are following the government of the people rather than the government of God. And this didn't just happen, my brothers and sisters. Here in our text in John chapter 6 and beginning at verse number 1, we have this particular account where Jesus feeds a multitude of people. The Bible says the number of the men were about 5,000, verse number 10. And so if each man had a wife and a child, that would have been 15,000 folk. Hello over here. And so forth and so on, you can multiply. But you see, the Bible just gives us the census count of the men. And the men in number were about 5,000. Jesus took two fish and five loaves and fed 5,000 men, not including women and children. Well, verse 2 of this particular text gives us a very interesting insight to the way people thought back then, which is similar to the way people think even today. The Bible says, and a great multitude followed him because they saw his miracles
which he did on them that were diseased. Here the Bible describes the fact that people followed Jesus because they liked the fact that he could heal sick folk. They didn't follow him because of his being the Son of God. They didn't follow him because of them coming to the conclusion that he was the long-awaited Messiah. But they followed Jesus because they saw what he could do. And then when they saw what he could do, they came to the conclusion that this is the man we need to hang around because we like what he's doing. Now, behind that, Jesus feeds 5,000 men, not including women and children, with 2 fish and 5 loaves of bread. Hello in here. Jesus, in addition to being able to heal me, this man can also feed me. Hello in here. And so when the multitudes began to follow him, they weren't following him because of a devotion to him. They were following him because of what they could get out of him.
Right.
Y'all gonna walk with me?
Right.
We got a lot of folk in religion today that are following Jesus, they think, because of what they can get out of him. I know that was the case because in verse number 14, the Bible said that those men, the 5,000 that we were talking about in verse 10, when those men, when they had seen the miracle that Jesus did, said, "This is of a truth that prophet that should come into the world." When Jesus therefore perceived that they would come and take him by force to make him a king, he departed again to a mountain himself alone. Jesus got away from them because he found out that they were going to make him a king because of their own selfish reason. They were with him for what they could get out of it. And when Jesus saw they trying to use me, he went all by himself. Y'all seeing this? Drop down to verse number 26 and 27. And once again, you'll see that the Lord understood that they were following him for what they could get out of him. He said, "Verily, verily, I say unto you, you seek me not because you saw the miracles, but because ye did eat of the loaves and were filled." You follow me? You are with me because you know I can satisfy your flesh. When you're hungry, you know I feed you. When you're thirsty, you know I give you something to drink. When you're naked, you know I clothe you. When you're sick, you know I heal you. You are not with me for me. You are not in it because you want to serve me with your whole heart, mind, and soul. You are in it because of what you can get out of me. Jesus said in verse 27, "Labor not for the meat which perish, but for the meat which endureth unto everlasting life." Those miracles were to show them emphatically that he was the Son of God. As a result of believing that he was the Son of God, they would have followed him because he was the Son of God and not because of the loaves and the fishes. How many of us are serving God for the loaves and the fishes? Can I talk to you this morning? How many of us are serving him for what we can get out of him? And that's the reason why when we feel as though that we're not getting out of him what it is we desire from him, and a little trouble comes our